that in the way?
Not at all.
What?
Can we share something?
Yeah.
I'll move out of y'all's way by the time I get to. He's done talking.
We have like 80 measures for us to start. So
okay.
We're good. There won't be measures, but it's still.
I can probably still make that.
Still good. You've got about 30 seconds to be coming.
Thank you.
do this concert again. It's been 3 years since we did this performance last. So it's wonderful to be here and see all of you, and such a lovely space to be in. Thanks to Otterbein United Methodist for allowing us to perform here. Just really thrilled to be in this space. So we started out with a traditional Gloucestershire wassail song. If you can imagine us showing up at your front door, that might be scary to have a whole brass band there. But yet that's what we did, or you came to us. So that was us sort of out and about in the village. And then the following piece was kind of, the party has now started, and we're here to give you some wonderful holiday sounds and entertaining music. Andrew Wainwright, who arranged the next medley, is a British composer and arranger who now lives in Dallas and performs with the Dallas Brass Band. And he has quite a catalog of really, really fine works, and he's churning them out all the time. It's such a nice thing to have such a fresh sound for the band. And so I hope you'll enjoy this Andrew Wainwright's Christmas Fantasia.
Thank you.
In 1944, the film Meet Me in St. Louis came out, and you heard Julie Garland sing this next song in the film. She plays a character, and she's singing it to her little sister of maybe 8-10 years old at the most. And they're living in St. Louis right before the St. Louis World's Fair. And I can't remember the plot. Some of you may know the film, but they're needing to move. And they're going to leave behind, all the kids are going to leave behind everything they ever knew and move someplace else in the country. And so her little sister's like, well, you know, I'm going to start packing. And she said, I can take all of my dolls and all my dead dolls. I think she had buried some of her dolls, if I remember correctly. And then she said, but what about the snowmen? There's like this whole snow family out of it. And they're talking about, well, it's a little hard to pack those up. And they're looking sort of melancholy, like out the window. And that's when Julie Garland begins to sing the song. So it has a bit of melancholy to it, but a gorgeous, gorgeous piece. And we don't have Judy Garland, but we do have Eva Bayliss, who's going to now perform for you. Have herself a Merry Little Christmas. attended a church in the area, and every Christmas there were these sisters that would sing this carol every single year, and it was the best part of Christmas Eve service. And the son of one of the sisters is now playing E-flat bass in the back. Are you looking? Okay. And to perform Candlelight Carol is the son of the sister's former high school band director. That's the only reason they're in the band, so I can make that connection. But anyways, this is a really lovely arrangement of this, a solo version of this piece, the Candlelight Carol. Please welcome to the front of the stage, Sean Mayhawk.
Thank you.
We have a piece that has three movements of Christmas music from the medieval period. This is not a music history lesson. These are settings by Philip Spark, and Philip has been writing for brass bands for decades at this point, and has a really great grasp on how to bring out the best of the sounds that this type of ensemble has. So these are maybe, if you will, more contemporary settings of very older pieces. So this is A Medieval Christmas by Philip Spark.
Thank you. Thank you.
he retired a while ago, but the chief arranger of the United States Marine Band in Washington, D.C., and has his background in the Salvation Army. So he has so many arrangements and original compositions written specifically for the Salvation Army. And there's this great collection of music called the American Band Journal that's published out of New York. It includes a lot of his music. Every publication that comes out, one of the pieces that comes out is one of his. And this is a lovely, lovely setting, just elegant setting of angels we have heard on high. And we're going to try and get Kyle to the front here without, you're going to be fine, right? But I'm so pleased to have such wonderful principals in this band and then to be able to showcase them as soloists. So would you, if you please welcome to play Angels on High, Kyle Remnant. Is really made and sounds the way it does, particularly because of these specific instruments. And they go way, way back into the 19th century. If you know a gentleman who invented the saxophone, Adolf Sax, he also, and less widely known, had a set of instruments called sax horns, or brass instruments, and these are the great-great-great-great-great-grandchildren of those instruments. So I thought it would be fun. One is to have this great piece at the most wonderful time of the year, but now the most wonderful time of the year is when you get to hear four tenor horns playing. So please welcome them here to the front of the stage, but it's the most wonderful time of the year. Wales, and the band has visited the area a couple of times, And he is really a great arranger and composer, and has such, I think, inventive ways of putting together familiar tunes into something new. So I think you're going to enjoy this Yule Dance.
And it could mean the Yule
Dance as well, so that's fine. If you want to.
Thank you.
in the United States and overseas in Great Britain, tied to communities and businesses and such. And in the U.S., the idea of a brass band kind of fell out of favor. John Philip Sousa, and it was more the military band that took over a bit. But there were always still town bands in the U.S. My dad tells stories of, you know, on any one given day, on a weekend, he might have played in three different town bands for different festivals and things like that. Well, in Great Britain, banding, it was so associated with factories and coal mining and textile mills and such, and that's where the roots of that type of ensemble came from. Well, if you know anything about the Salvation Army, during the temperance movement, moving at the end of the 19th century, they figured, well, why can't we have a brass band as well? And so the brass bands and the Salvation Army are still intertwined in the United States. Some of the very finest bands that we have in the country are ones such as the Chicago Staff Band, the Southern Territorial Band, and certainly the New York Staff Band. Wonderful. And when we first started doing a holiday program, it immediately came to mind that the one organization that we should support, trying to bring people in, hopefully through their generosity, through your generosity, would be helping is the Salvation Army. And we're thrilled to be able to, again, present a program where the proceeds will go to that wonderful organization. And it's near and dear to my heart, not because I was ever in it, but because I have a lot of friends who played in brass bands with the Salvation Army. We've done a lot of literature. And so I hope that you will be generous with an organization that does a lot of good, especially at this time of year when people sorely need that kind of comfort and assistance. It would be just great. So the Salvation Army will thank you, and we thank you as well. So our party has ended. I hope that you, I saw no one dancing. Was anybody dancing? My back was turned. Was anybody dancing? Were they in the aisles? Yes, a little bit. Sort of dancing in your seat, maybe a little bit. So we're going to finish with a really nice medley, march medley, that Jim Anderson, who for quite a number of years was the director of the National Capital Salvation Army Band, another really wonderful band. And this is entitled Seasons Greetings. We thank you all for being here. Merry Christmas. Enjoy your holiday season. Enjoy family. And thank you for supporting the band. Please always keep an eye out for our next concert. We're going to take a little break to ice down over the holidays and come back and have a new program for you in the spring. So thank you so very much. This is Seasons Greetings. Thank you. appreciate it. And I want to thank you for being here for this concert. Have a great rest of the evening, and please watch out for our next concerts. Thank you.